Welcome, allesamen. Germanic culture and language is a huge part of the British Isles. The British Isles, along with most of Europe actually, was Celtic originally, with a lot of Germanic migration involved in it. And this is a very important question because so many of you ask on this channel, people from the British Isles or others around the world who have British ancestry, they're very interested in the Norse religion and they wonder, is this the religion right for me? Or is it just for Scandinavians? Or is this an ancestral religion of the British Isles as well? Short answer, yes, actually. It's not just a Norse or Scandinavian religion, but a Germanic tribal religion. All Germanic peoples practice this religion at some point in time. The gods' names and practices, of course, were slightly different, but the same religion essentially, and the British Isles are absolutely a place that received a lot of Germanic migration and a place where the Germanic religion was practiced. But the history books tell us quite a different thing than what the DNA studies do. So what I'm going to go over in this video is answering the questions that many of you have. Is Germanic or maybe Celtic paganism the best for you and your ancestry? I'm going to look at the DNA studies in just a second, but first, just going over quickly what the history books say. There was not one, not two, but three massive waves of Germanic migration to the British Isles. The first and biggest one comes in the migration period. In the England area, the native Britons were living there first, Celtic people who had been inhabited by the Romans for a little bit of time. After the Roman Empire fell, the Roman soldiers withdrew out of England and the Anglo-Saxons came in, like you see here. In the next few hundred years, they immigrated to England and pushed all the native Britons out of the area, like you see on these maps. Almost all England was dominated by Angles, Saxons, and Jutes, which were Germanic peoples from northern Germany, southern Denmark area. So again, this is what the history books tell us, but the DNA studies show something different, which I'm getting to right now. So yes, England at least had Germanic people, Germanic language, and Germanic religion here, same religion as the Norse, but they were calling their gods Woden and Thunod instead of Thor and Odin. Eventually, they all Christianized, but this was the established religion in England for a few hundred years at least, and the rest of the British Isles remained Celtic at this point. Anyway, fast forward a couple hundred years to the Viking Age. The Vikings, too, were a Germanic people, and they migrated to England in large numbers. England was actually part of the Danish kingdom numerous times during the Viking Age, and we also see lots of Viking migration now into Ireland and Scotland. These areas especially were Viking settlements, but they integrated pretty quickly and converted to Christianity within a couple generations. But yes, for sure, in all of these areas, the Norse religion would have been practiced. Fast forward another couple hundred years, and this brings us to our third massive wave of Germanic migration, the Normans, in 1066. So the Normans were basically Vikings that were given this area in northern France. The male warriors from Scandinavia were settling there and taking nice Frankish wives and some good strong Viking genetics there. William the Conqueror was actually a descendant of Rollo, or Rolf as we would say in Old Norse. But the Norman genetics was probably honestly 50-50, you know, kind of 50% Viking, maybe even a little bit less at this time, but still. Norman invasion of England happened in 1066, and they have kind of been ruling ever since then, really. So that is three big waves of Germanic migration. So from the history books, it would seem that the culture of Britain, especially England, is going to be mostly Germanic. Even today, English is a Germanic language that we all speak, with almost no trace of any Celtic words, actually, that we use in day-to-day speech. Germanic family names we have, place names, architecture, old inscriptions, historical monuments, old written sources, ruling powers, all says Germanic, but the DNA results say something different. So this is exactly what we're going to look at here, some of the DNA studies that I've been able to find online, and I'll link them all below here so you can see. One comes from thescotsman.com, says that England is 64% Celt, Almost as high as Scotland, actually, which is 73% Celt. I would have expected Scotland to be a lot higher Celtic DNA, but I guess that just shows how much the Vikings settled there and how the Germanic DNA got in there. Not surprising that we see here the highest percentage of Celtic DNA in the British Isles is Wales. So the Welsh are probably the closest to what the native Britons originally looked like. Also here it says Viking Scandinavian DNA is only about 20% in most places in the British Isles, except of course in Scotland there it's a bit higher. In the Northern Isles it's up to 40%. I thought that would honestly be much higher. I thought that would be damn near 100% up there. These, you know, islands during the Viking Age, they were not really inhabited before the Vikings settled there, and even after that there was very little migration there. So even Scots that you meet up there, the ones that I meet in modern times, they pretty much tell me that they're 100% Viking, and I believe them. Just, you can tell by the way that they look, but that's just my thoughts. At least the DNA study says about 40% Viking. Another article here, Daily Mail. Okay, this one has a really cool map that you can see. Lots of differences. Most parts of England has a quarter German and 45% French. But don't forget, guys, the French too are a real good mix of Celtic and Germanic peoples. The Gauls were the tribes originally living in what is now France. They were a Celtic people, but then the Franks came in and the Burgundians, and they took over in the migration period over large parts of what is now France. So the Franks were a Germanic tribe, but the population there too is quite mixed. Okay, another super cool map here. Yeah, also remember that Germanic DNA is going to be different depending on where in the UK you come from. Even in England, if you're around York or Jørvik, as it was called in the Viking Age, you would have much more Viking DNA than somewhere else in the British Isles, because this was actually the Viking capital of England after all. And there are plenty of other places like that, so this is always going to vary. Another one here, The Guardian. This one says that the Vikings and the Normans didn't leave much trace of their DNA in the UK. England is about 30% DNA shared with modern-day Germans. Of course, this comes from the migration period, about 1700 years ago. Angles, Saxons, and Jutes. Okay, then this one is really good. See, this is, here it says the participants were all white British, lived in rural areas, and had four grandparents all born within 50 miles of each other. So guys, this is so important when you do studies like this. If you just test the DNA, you know, of random people these days, especially living in big cities with all the migration that we've had in the past few generations, it's going to tell us nothing about the DNA that has been there over many hundreds or thousands of years. It's actually going to lead you the wrong way. But if you get out to the countryside, especially people who have had the same farm in their family for many generations, that is going to have the highest chance that it represents the genetics of that area going very far back. Now this is, I'm going over one last one. This is an academic paper. It's causing a bit of a fuss lately, and they've found some really interesting new things that we didn't know before. If you've watched any of my other videos, you know I don't really like DNA tests, and that's why I don't talk about DNA on this channel like other pagan or history YouTubers. It's because most DNA tests are all shit. Most DNA tests, all they do is compare your DNA to others in modern day countries, and that's how you get the results. Many of these countries that they're comparing to have had mixing and migration for thousands of years now, so it tells us absolutely nothing. So if we compare our DNA to that of ancient humans, on the other hand, now we're getting somewhere. That is, of course, going to be more accurate to what the population would have been like back then. But of course, this is much harder because all we have are a few skeletons from that time. But this paper basically studied the skull shape and determined of these old skeletons at various locations in England. And they were, were they mainland northwest versus British native? So basically, were they Germanic or were they Celtic during the migration period and the Iron Ages? And what they found right in the early migration period, right when these Germanic migrations happened all over most of England, there was 75% Germanic people almost, and very few native Celtic Britons there. But just a couple hundred years later, when they studied the skeletons from then, Celtic DNA had come back strong. So an initial move out when the Germanic tribes came in, and then the Celtic peoples moved back in later on. And this is why we have so much Celtic DNA in the British Isles today, opposed to what the history books tell us. So Germanic peoples did migrate and take over for quite some time, but the Celts came back, probably had more children per household, and the Celts built their population back in England, even though the ruling powers were Germanic, Anglo-Saxon, of course. It's far more than the history books tell us, so guys, this is normal. Remember, history is written by the winners. Germanic peoples invaded the British Isles many times successfully. That's why in the British Isles and other places around the world, we speak a Germanic language. English is a Germanic language. That's why we have Germanic place names, Germanic religion, inscriptions, and all that other stuff I went over. All that doesn't necessarily mean that the Germanic people were the majority in that population back then. For example, I think if, you know, they did some modern DNA studies on the British ancestry, you know, the royal family or like a noble kind of upper ruling class over the last few hundred years, I think the DNA results would show much more Germanic than the general population would. But yeah, it's just a note. There is no one answer here. The truth is, if you have British ancestry, there is no one-size-fits-all. You might find someone who is 90% Germanic, and then his next-door neighbor is going to be 90% Celtic. So overall, there is more Celtic DNA in the British Isles, but really, you have to look at all these yourself and look at your own family history. Honestly, a better DNA test is simply looking in the mirror and your family history. I don't like DNA tests at all. And go to what calls to you. You know, the legends and mythology and history of people and, you know, the landscapes and the nature that make you feel at home. These memories are in our DNA and they're in there from past lives. So go to what calls to you. Just realize there's a Viking craze right now. I think more comments than anything else I get on my channel is people trying to show that they have Viking DNA somehow. This is just the trend right now, okay? And you guys need to realize that and be honest with yourself. Everyone wants to be Norse after watching Vikings and The Last Kingdom and the Marvel series and all this stuff. In 10 years from now, they might, some Hollywood producer will come out and make a great TV series about the Celts, and all of a sudden everybody's Celtic now and wants to prove their Celtic ancestry. So being Norse, just remember it's the fad right now. If the Norse religion calls to you, great, but don't ignore some of your Celtic history. We need to be honest with ourselves and do some research into your own family's history to realize what spirituality is going to call to you a bit more. And I think if people actually take the time to look into their own spirituality, they're going to naturally feel a higher calling to your own ancestry. I would love to see lots more people getting into Celtic paganism, especially those with ancestry in the British Isles. It's a good mix there, but definitely overall more Celtic. Celtic paganism, honestly, is just as cool. There is no pagan religion better than others. They're all equally awesome. And Celtic is not very different to the Norse or Germanic religion at all. So, and now more than ever, I think we all need to work together as, you know, just pagans or just spiritual people or just people who are interested and proud of our own history because we can learn from each other. For example, the Celts have very little texts preserved about their religion, but lots of holidays, lots of traditions. The Norse have lots of texts about their religion and myths, but very little about their traditions. So we can compare these things and fill in the blanks and learn from each other. Because we are just cousins, after all, in the same Indo-European family. And if we go back far enough, we were all one people. So that's all I have to say for today. Hope you enjoyed. That's a little historical education and some DNA little studies to point you in the right way. So that's all I have to say for today. Vi ses neste gang.